Good morning, everybody in Canada, USA, Latin America, all my brothers and sisters. I hope you're taking care of yourself, your family, your friends, your neighbors, and everybody whosoever is associated with you. All our brothers and sisters, please take care of your health and your wellness. If you're healthy, if your health is fine, if you're mentally robust, the whole world and the whole planet is going to be wonderful. Enjoy your morning jog. Enjoy your morning walk and enjoy your cup of coffee and tea, whatsoever you're holding. Go ahead with that. And next 1 hour, we are going to be connected heart to heart, soul to soul, mind to mind. And we're going to share a lot how to make the world a better place for all of us. So brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, world over, let me move from Canada, USA and Latin America, coming to Europe. I know you enjoyed your lunch wonderful, and you're also taking care of yourself. Please look after yourself, stay healthy, stay fit, stay fine. Mentally, you've got to be tough and robust. Your body will follow, your immune system will follow, everything would follow. Look at me at 70, right talking to you. I feel like a young boy of 20 years old. Because I enjoy, I'm passionate, I'm positive, I'm energetic. Similar way, I want to see the whole world and everybody. If I'm happy, the world is happy. And that is the way all my brothers and sisters in Europe, after having your lunch, give us a little time before you go for your evening tea and coffee. Let me move to Central Asia. I'm coming to Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, Afghanistan, all the places when I come to, we extend you a very warm welcome. You join us every evening. And I'm so happy that a lot of foreign institutions also, which are located in these countries for the skills, for the competencies, for higher education, they also come and they join this particular program. A very hearty welcome to each one of you. But at the same time, caution, got to take care of your health. And of course, with that, wellness. Let me come to Middle East because this evening is dedicated to Middle East and this evening is dedicated to Assalamu Alaikum to everybody, all my brothers and sisters, those are located in the Middle East, because this evening we are going to have three of the distinguished warriors from the education fraternity. Those are located in Qatar, Oman, and Kuwait. They are going to share their thought processes, their pedagogy, their vision, and their futurology, whatever can be done to make education relevant. Now, it's a global conference of educators and motivators. So I'm coming from Middle East to India. Namaskar. Sab bhai bheno ko jo Bharat mein hai, aap sab ko aaj ki sandhya mein bahut bahut namaskar aur pranam. आज हिज होलीनेस दलाई लामा जी का बर्थडे भी है, उनका जन्मदिन भी है 85, तो उनको भी बहुत सारी शुभकामनाएं. और सारे हमारे जितने भाई बहन बुद्धिस्ट हैं, उन सब लोगों को जहां भी हैं, 500 मिलियन पीपल, उनको भी हमारी बहुत सारी शुभकामनाएं आज की शाम. भारत के हर निवासी को, हर इंसान को, जो भी जहां पर, किसी भी राज्य में, किसी भी डिस्ट्रिक्ट में, किसी भी जगह पर है, अपना ख्याल रखिए, अपनी फैमिली का ख्याल रखिए, परिवार के साथ ठीक से रहिए. वसुधैव कुटुंबकम, क्योंकि पूरा संसार ही फैमिली है, पूरा संसार ही एक परिवार है. वही हमारी संस्कृति है, वही हमारी सभ्यता है, वही हमारा कल्चर है, वही हमारा हेरिटेज है. और यहां से थोड़ा सा आगे लेके चलता हूं तो आ जाइए, बहुत सारी चीज साउथ ईस्ट एशिया में भी आज की शाम हमारे साथ जुड़ रही है. Hearty welcome to all my brothers and sisters from Southeast Asia, right starting from Myanmar to Cambodia to Laos to Singapore to Malaysia to Indonesia to Philippines. And then, of course, from there, I'm coming to Bahrain also. And then, of course, we get the people out of ASEAN, the next route in Bahrain also. So hearty welcome to all of you. Great, great salutations and hearty welcome. 650 million people located in ASEAN as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, all our brothers and sisters and the global family together, what is the purpose of this particular webinar? What is the purpose of this particular program? What do we want to achieve from this particular program? How are we getting the global confluence of educators and motivators together to empower the entire education system? Ultimately, it is youth empowerment. It's youth skills and youth competencies that has to be taken care of. We started this journey on 5th of June. That's the World Environment Day. And we are taking it till 15th of August 2020, Bharat ke Svatantrata Divas tak. Aur hamari is journey mein, hamare is prayas mein, from the world over, all the people, those are directly or indirectly, whether you're principal, your vice chancellor, your director, your teacher, your counselor, your motivator, your technical expert, you're giving any kind of a support to the ecosystem of education. 10 lakh logo ko, 10 lakh people from the world over, 1 million people, all of us, we will be together by 15th of August 2020, making education relevant. Global confluence of educators and motivators. Doctors are warriors, nurses, paramedical, they are doing service their own way. But at the same time, our teachers are also doing great job. Our education fraternity is also doing a great job. They are warrior in their own way. They're trying to reach out children wherever they are. So ladies and gentlemen, those of us who have joined us on this webinar, it's pretty fine. We extend you a very hearty welcome. Those have come directly on this webinar, but if you are unable to join on this webinar, I would request those my brothers and sisters, please pass on the word to others. They can watch us live on the Facebook as well. The same program is coming world over. The whole family is growing. There is no platform of the social media which can handle the gathering what we are having. So thereby we have opened the watch party and we have opened the Facebook. You can come on Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page. We have listed over here. Please read it. Come on that watch page. Watch page ko bhi open kijiye. Try and gather everybody. So, while extending a very hearty welcome to Mr. T. Prem Kumar, the Principal, Indian Educational School, Kuwait. Madam Papri Ghosh, Principal, Indian School, Al Guba, Muscat Sultanate of Oman. Mr. Saeed Shaukat Ali, Principal, Ideal Indian School, Qatar. They are my three warriors. They are my three distinguished guests. They are my esteemed guests. And they are the celebrities this evening. Like it happens in the film industry, media entertainment industry, I'm going to introduce these three celebrities and warriors a little later. But before that, I want to give you the whole profile and the chronology of this entire program. Why did we start on 5th of June? Why we are carrying till 15th of August? What have we done so far and what do we want to achieve? And what is the objective and the necessity of this particular program? Ladies and gentlemen, let me share a couple of slides with you quickly so that we all are together. Our chamber, ICSI, when I talk about, ladies and gentlemen, International Chamber for Service Industry. It deals with the non-resident Indians, consultancy, research, innovative strategies, new pedagogies and whatsoever can come with training skills and other things. It's a government, corporate and non-resident Indians business interface. 30 million brothers and sisters are abroad in different countries. Those have gone from India. Their strength is increasing. They are doing wonders. They bring proud to us. They bring so much of knowledge reservoir, technocrats. They are experts in different fields wherever they are. So Monday to Friday, all of us, we are together to empower the entire education system. And on every Saturday, we join together where we discuss with you Ayurveda for the global wellness. So that is the kind of a system we have got Monday to Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. India's time, absolutely on education relevance, and Saturday on your health and wellness. Now, let me proceed. As per the UNESCO, almost 1.6 billion children world over, ladies and gentlemen, they are confined, they are locked in their respective residences. They are with their parents. They are not in a position to go to schools, colleges, institutions. We got to be taking care of them. Teachers, principals, educators are trying their level best to reach them wherever they are, whatsoever best we can do. And we know there's a different pedagogy which is being applied at this point of time. There are different innovative, creative, collaborative techniques are being applied during this lockdown COVID-19, and technology is playing very important role. There are TV channels, community radio, mobile phone, electronic gadgets, whatever is available. Every teacher is trying to reach out their children world over so that they all can be benefited. Ladies and gentlemen, at the same time, our chamber, every day, we have got a beaming world over. We are trying to help the youth, the teachers, the principals, the educators, whosoever is coming in contact with us. All of us, we are getting together and we are trying and working out a strategy, what chamber can do from our side. And there's a concept of finishing school, what we have got. That's on your personality, your communication skills, your positivity, your positive attitude, your positive thought process, your music therapy, your gaming therapy, your innovative, cognitive, collaborative, whatsoever skills and competencies can be acquired. That is also the integral part what we have taken in this entire process. So institutions abroad, whosoever is keen, we would be more than happy to do the beaming for you right from here to help you out. No charges, please, free of cost, because it's a gesture from the chamber. Now, education should be relevant to our day-to-day life. I think the parents and the youth and children, students, whosoever we are during this lockdown, we must have realized and we must have noticed what is the relevance of that education what we are taking in school, college, polytechnic, ITI, higher education, university, institutions. Try and do this during lockdown. Can your child repair the tap, water tap? Can your child fix up the gadgets in the wash basin or in the kitchen? Can your child repair the tube light, or can they change the bulb, whatever is required for the electricity? Can your child, or do children know which particular organic vegetable is grown in which time? What is to be done on the rooftop? How to make optimum use of the space? There are so many gadgets, so many things which can be done. We can help. Parents can help children. Teachers can also help children along with your subjects and contents, whatever you are trying to give them in their academics. Try and give them some notes. This also in day-to-day life, how to think positive, how to live healthy, how to take care of yourself, how to have positivity all the time. Music therapy is very important. I believe in music therapy so much because after my PhD now, I'm working towards the DLET, which is going on. The relevance of music therapy as a new pedagogy in empowering the entire education system. It's very important. Now, our chamber, ICSI, International Chamber for Service Industry, started this webinar series and this journey in a very humble way, making education relevant. On 5th of June, that's World Environment Day. And we are continuing till 15th of August, 2020, Bharat Ke Swatantrata Divas Tak. And we have taken the theme, water conservation. Jal bachaiye, pani bachaiye, neer bachaiye. Whatsoever, every drop of water is so important to all of us because the whole world is going to have a difficulty on that. Last 2.5 months, ladies and gentlemen, our chamber has done a lot of research. And all our presidents, advisors, research scholars, world over in 149 countries, when we have done the confluence of that entire information together, we share and we wish to bring to your notices the golden triangle, what we talk about, what was Delhi, Agra, Jaipur in India earlier. The golden triangle is now is first preference is basic food. Please take care of the food. Grow organic food, eat healthy food, take nutrition food, whatsoever best you can take to your body. If you are going to be physically fine and mentally fine, your 99% problem is over, 1% we can look after. So start growing organic vegetables on the rooftop, in the kitchen garden, wherever you have got a space in your residence, start growing vegetables. It will help you a lot. Basic agriculture, basic farming, basic nutrition, and whatever organic can be done in your residence. So agriculture and animal husbandry is the base what we have to take care of. Second part, your health. Health and wellness, of course, there are going to be a lot of careers, new opportunities, jobs, technical, non-technical, others, those are going to be. But health, herbal, happiness, and holistic healing is the second mantra which we have to take care of. That's your physical and your mental wellness and fitness is very important. And third part, all my educators world over, those are thinking that this pandemic is going to get over, is going to get over soon, and you will get back to your schools, colleges, institutions, and all that. Ladies and gentlemen, try and go back to the era, what happened in 1918, 20, 25, 1930. I do not want to repeat that, but I just wish to share with all of you, education will never, ever get back to the classroom the way it used to be in month of January, February, 2020. There is going to be a new innovations. Technology is going to play a very important role. A lot of people world over are going to lose jobs. There are going to be a new avenues which will come up because every time necessity is the mother of invention we talk about, learn and earn, that will come into force and there'll be digital education. And the entire model of the world is going to be based on sustainable development. We are doing a research with one of the institutions in Switzerland. It's called SUMAS, S-U-M-A-S. That is the only institution which has got graduation, post-graduation, diploma, certificate, MBA, PhD, and D-Lit in sustainable development. We are doing a lot of program with them. And the finding finally, which we come on to is B2B will not be known anymore business to business. It will be termed as back to basics of life. Start realizing that. That is very important. Every month, we have got one winner. Every month, we have got one educator. Almost from the world over, we have developed such a beautiful podlock. There is a confluence of teachers, educators, innovators, policymakers, motivators, counselors, and they all are giving a lot of ideas. The winner of the month of June 2020, there is a lady, and she sent across this, which I wish to share with all of you, because ladies and gentlemen, Ayurveda, because first of all, we didn't do the emblem of that in this country. The people took away the pedagogy with them only. Most of the Ayurvedists, they didn't share with the public and with the audience and with the society. It's a very unfortunate part. Knowledge is always to be shared. When you share the knowledge, you pass the knowledge to the next generation, subsequent generation. It's a shame if we disappear from this planet without contributing something substantial to this planet. Winner for the June 2020 ICSI Education Innovation Award. We wish to share six little stories. And I will encourage all the parents, all teachers, everybody world over, wherever you are, life is based on stories. You write so many books on Amazon, you see, it's a life story of so many people. Any book you come across, they try and relate their life story. Nobody has born into riches. From the rags to the riches, people have moved in and all. Six little stories, and this lady is the winner. And she says, six thought processes. Number one. Once all villagers decided to pray for the rain. On the day of the prayer, all the people gathered, but only one boy came with an umbrella. That is called faith. Number two, when you throw babies in the air, small child you throw in the air as a parent, they laugh because they know you will catch them. That is the trust. Every night we go to bed without any assurance of being alive the next morning. But still we set the alarms to wake up in the morning. That is hope. We plan big things for tomorrow in spite of zero knowledge of the future. That is confidence. We see the world suffering, but still, I do not want to emphasize too much onto it because it's just to laugh only. We get married and have children, and that is love. Sixth point. On an old man's shirt was written a sentence. I'm relating to myself also. When I'm 70 year old and this 70 year old young man is talking to you with the energy of 20 year young boy, that is the dopamine I carry. So point number six. And also see, in Japan, there is a place called Okinawa. And Okinawans, what they do, nobody is less than 100 years old over there. When we traveled with the Honorable Prime Minister of India in Japan, it was worth noticing Sapporo, Hokkaido, Kobe, Kyoto, Fukuoka, Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Yokohama, Tokyo, what all they are doing. And Shivasana Ratio Tatako, Shivasana Taido, the Shimeso, and Okinawa, what exactly it is. The sixth point. On an old man's shirt was written a sentence, I am not 80 years old, I am sweet 16 with 64 years of experience. That is attitude. Have a happy day wherever you are. Happy afternoon, happy evening, and live your life like these six stories. Remember, when you talk about this, remember, this is very important. Good friends are the rare jewels of your life, difficult to find and impossible to replace. So, ladies and gentlemen, this evening for the month of June, and you could also be one of like her, you can send your innovative ideas and creative thoughts to us, to ICSI, and you never know, right from the fraternity, those are watching this particular program today, knowledge is to be shared. Information is to be shared. Where it is to be shared, I will share with you. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce June 2020. The winner of the month is Madam Nalini Asthana. She's an NGO making education relevant. For this webinar series, she has got the award for the most outstanding creative idea, and that we called as a teacher for the month of June 2020. It's a global confluence of educators and motivators. So heartiest congratulations to Madam Nalini Asthana. I hope you are watching, your parents are also watching, and it's a great, great, great big salutation, regards, and congratulations to you for being the winner for the June. And I hope somebody else is going to be in July from the people those are joining us today with this particular webinar. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the important slide for all of you. The human brain, everything is moving, let it move. Because the music of life, enjoy every moment of your life. That music works as a lubricant, and it removes the friction. It does so well in life. Whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe can achieve. We are going to achieve a target of 1 million educators from the entire world. Those are going to be the part of this particular campaign on Bharat Satantrata Divas on 15th of August. That is the pledge our chamber has taken. We have dedicated the entire energy, our all educators and all advisors, all research scholars, everybody from this chamber world over is trying to reach out the best brains, creative brains, positive brains, policy makers, because we do not need education, theoretical policies. We need action plans, pragmatic and practical, not lying down in the almirahs, but which are implementable. Those are deliverable. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, who is to be benefited? Youth. We got to understand at the end of the tunnel, parents, you also understand. Teachers, you also understand. And as an educator, as a motivator, I also wish to understand. We got to understand what youth wants, what youth thinks, what youth is innovative ideas. You can't imagine these millennials, those are born, they've got wonderful thought processes. They've got wonderful ideas. Arey, give them a chance. Give them an opportunity. Let them come forward. I learn from my son. I learn from my daughter. I learn from my grandchild. And he comes to me sometime and he says, Nanu, do you know what is galaxy? How many planets are there and all? And that time I look at it. Look at this child knowing so much. And he shows me on the mobile. So, ladies and gentlemen, today's children are the future of the world tomorrow. Let's love them, respect them, embrace them, and give them the beautiful hug. Youth have to be understood very well. Let's come together, Global Education Empowerment, International Chamber for Service Industry. Should you wish to send your idea, should you wish to send any story, should you wish to become a panelist in this particular program, kindly send your email at innovation, because innovation is everything for future. innovation@icsi.asia. We have also got WhatsApp numbers over here, which are listed. You can see in your own time. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the time now. From here, I move to my three celebrities. Those are the warriors this evening. And they are my esteemed guests this evening. Those are going to make this evening. And they are so wonderful. Let me extend a very warm welcome to Mr. T. Prem Kumar, the principal, Indian Educational School, Kuwait. A very big hand, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you are, please put your hands together. The Honorable Prime Minister of India told, thali bajaiye, ghanti bajaiye, shankh bajaiye, aur doctors ke liye, warriors ke liye humne kiya. To aaj main aapko bolta hoon, clap kijiye in principals ke liye, in teachers ke liye, in educators ke liye, in counselors ke liye, and all the people, those are with the education fraternity, ladies and gentlemen. While extending our best wishes to everybody in Kuwait, Mr. T. Prem Kumar, appointed by the CBSE as a telecounselor and mentor to the CBSE school in UAE, Kuwait and Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, academic coordinator of the Science India Forum, Muscat, an organization under the Vigyan Bharati of India, served as the chairman of the Gulf Council of the CBSE affiliated schools in the Middle East in 2019 and 20. Mr. Prem Kumar is a motivational speaker, storyteller, a trainer, and avid sports person who has received many awards for his contribution in education. A very hearty welcome to my first warrior, Mr. T. Prem Kumar, the principal. I've got second celebrity this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please put your hands together and extend a very warm welcome to Madam Papri Ghosh, the principal, Indian School, Al Ghubra, Muscat, Oman. She has been the regional trustee of the Round Square for the South Asia and the Gulf region for the last 6 years. She's also a member on the board of Global Connections. Her bonding with Indian School, Al Ghubra, was long back since 1991. Her interest includes music, theater, reading, and those are fond of eating and cooking as well. So extending a very hearty welcome. Before your mouth starts watering, let me roll over to the third guest. After extending a hearty welcome to Madam Papri Ghosh, let me go to ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Saeed Shaukat Ali, Principal, Ideal Indian School, Qatar. Assalamu alaikum. He is dedicated, resourceful, and goal-driven educator with diverse experience of more than 24 years as principal and strong track record fostering child-centered curriculum and student creativity. It was a pleasure to know that he became the principal at the age of 26, coming from Bangalore, Karnataka, like Prem Kumarji from originally Kerala and then to Tamil Nadu and then, of course, other places as well in the country. So Saeed Saab, committed to professional ethics, standards of practice while caring for the education of the young children, experience in developing curriculum as well as conducting teachers training and parenting programs. So my deep regards and thanks to everybody in Qatar and hearty welcome to all my brothers and sisters and our friends in these countries. So ladies and gentlemen, with these words, let me invite and extend a very warm welcome to Mr. Saeed Shaukat Aliji, the principal, Ideal Indian School, Qatar. And let's give the fragrance this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, we have become friends since yesterday. He has shared so much of Karnataka, Grish Karnad, and all the old memories, youngest principal at the age of 26. And I told him when I was 26, what I was doing in Bangalore and all the area. So much of fragrance coming together. I extend a very warm welcome to Saeed Shaukat Aliji, Let's, ladies and gentlemen, all of us travel together to Qatar now.
Thank you, Dr. Sharma ji. If you want me to speak in Punjabi, chagayo tusi, bhalle bhalle.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, first I'll share my slides and I'll start my talk.
Sure, sir. Sure, sir.
Indeed, it is pleasure to be part of this program with my senior most colleagues as panelists, Sir Prem Kumar and Madam Papri Ghosh. I admire them because they are seniors to me. And no doubt, my young friend, Dr. Sharma ji, as he told, he's 20 years young. So after seeing him, I too got a lot of energy today. So I feel now I am 16 years old, even though I am 50 now. I'll start with a quote. Our good deeds will travel with us far. Our good deeds will travel with us far. What we were up to, what we are. What we were up to, what we are. Dear Sharma sir, I am glad and privileged to be part of your webinar series. Indeed, ICSC is doing excellent work to spread awareness of education across the globe. My good evening to you, my fellow panelists, all my teachers who are watching this webinar, all viewers who are seeing this webinar, all parents who are seeing this webinar, all my brothers and sisters who are seeing this webinar, and even my lovely students. Good evening, assalamu alaikum, sasri akal, vanakkam, and great morning to people living in Canada and other part of the globe. COVID-19 or coronavirus started spreading like wildfire across the globe. 80 to 85% of the globe started shutdown, lockdown, shutdowns, and schools are closed. Still, schools are closed, buildings are closed, but teachers are working more than earlier, and teaching is happening. Nobody can stop teaching learning process. And we, as the administrators, as the principals, we never gave time to our teachers for shifting their normal face-to-face learning system to online learning system. But our teachers are genius. I salute almost all the teachers. And I can tell, unlike doctors and nurses, even teachers are also COVID warriors. Whenever I speak to my teachers, I usually tell that teachers understand one thing. If you are not updated, you are outdated. Teachers, please understand one thing. If you are not updated, you are outdated. My teachers and all other teachers, because every school started remote learning. Every school started virtual classes. Because parents were panicked, students were panicked, whether education will continue, whether classes will continue, how it will continue. And we should salute even parents, because with their cooperation, we could manage to conduct online classes very, very well. Teachers immediately, as education went for paradigm shift from face-to-face learning to online learning system, our teachers developed immediately adaptability. They adapted to online teaching method. Even though few teachers initially faced certain technical problems, but gradually all senior teachers, they also became techno-friendly. As we are the teachers, even I am the teacher, I teach biology. We teachers believe in ourselves that learning should go on. If you are learning from your child, no problem. If you are learning some new thing, you can learn. Learn, unlearn, relearn should happen every day, every second, every minute in our life. And life is a good teacher. And I had very good teachers also. Life itself is a good teacher, is teaching all new things every day. You know, coronavirus has taught a new lesson for all of us. The lesson is, we can even teach virtually. We can even teach by using technology. You can even imbibe new knowledges, and you can even spread peace everywhere. How ICS is spreading education across the globe? Every organization is spreading peace and harmony across the globe. But today's topic, I felt I'll talk about futuristic education. And my futuristic education. So I have written one topic there on the top. Today is best to make our school resilient. Do it now. See, everybody started thinking now, when will the school reopen? Whether our teachers will allow us to go for classes? Or again, the teachers will tell, no, you maintain social distancing. How our classes will happen? Whether the classes will happen in the same way how it was happening earlier? So these questions are running amongst majority of parents, majority of students. Even we as an educator, we are also thinking about the same. Even Ministry of Education Qatar and Ministry of Education in all places, they're planning SOPs for starting the school gradually. Now, in future, the education will be in the blended form. So blended learning will be the future learning, a future schooling. Now, what is blended learning? So I've given in a diagram in the figure there. Blended learning is an approach to learn that combining the face-to-face and online learning experience, ideally each both online and offline, with complementing other by using particular strength. Contest, while generally seen in the trend in progressive learning, blended learning can also be viewed as a kind of realistic symbol where the gap between traditional education for the last century, so as a brick and mortar schooling, to digital learning system. This course implies to digital only. In future, ultimately, there will be incarnation of the online as an offline learning system. Blended learning can happen in any ways. Blended learning will be of different types. Flipped classrooms, where teachers will be able to record their videos in advance. And the recorded videos can be sent through YouTube and various other channels such that it will reach to the students. But in this pattern, the students can see video anytime, whenever he is free, anywhere across the globe. But the problem he can face is he can directly cannot interact with the teacher. Either he has to call the teacher, either he or she has to WhatsApp the teacher to interact with the teacher when you go for flipped classroom. The second kind of classroom is again hybrid learning. Hybrid learning is again combination of both teaching and non-teaching, means the teaching online as well as offline. But in hybrid learning, what will happen, there will be no direct interaction. But in blended learning form, partly the student will be in the school, partly he'll continue the classes at home, So because at home, it is his comfortable zone or comfort zone where he can learn. The teachers can teach offline as well as online to continue the education system. According to UNESCO, the future education will be in the blended form. Even UNESCO also approved that futuristic school, future education will be always in the blended form. Even our senior friend Prem Kumar sir told in the last that blended learning will be the future of learning. You know, students need the teacher's help every time. Students need teacher every time. Either virtually, either physically, the teaching should happen. The teaching should go on. Learning should go on. It is happening now. Almost all schools across the globe, by various platforms, either by Zoom, either by Microsoft Teams, either by Google Classroom, either by other forms like Skype IDs, and even some of them are doing classes from Emo calls, and some classes are even happening through WhatsApp calls also. And India, CBSE board has created a separate YouTube channel. There are different apps like Diksha app and Vidyadhyan app. And further, we can even see that there are live TVs which are installed where the internet connection is not available. So teaching learning process, even though from past 3.5 months schools are closed, but teachers are doing their job. Teachers are teaching, and we have to salute the each and every teacher. You know, blended learning involves following things. Now in this slide, you can please focus on this slide. First one is direct instruction. So direct instruction here, teacher will be directly teaching physically in the classroom. This is again the old traditional method. Then second method is really important, peer-to-peer coaching. You know, peer-to-peer coaching is the teaching happening amongst the students. In my school, I have created an environment called a mentor system, student mentor system, as well as teacher's mentor system. In a classroom, if there are student number is 30 or 40, I will appoint 4 students as mentor. Amongst the 4 students, every month one student will be a monthly senior mentor. Now, what will be the job of this mentor? See, as we believe in peer learning, peer coaching, the mentors, what they'll do, they'll see that their friends come with proper uniform, they complete their all assignments and worksheets, they keep all their books intact properly, and keep the classroom tidy and neat. That was the job given to one mentor. And for every 10 children, one mentor. So this had a big effect, or we can see the impact of this mentor system in the school, where the discipline improved and peer learning happened. Because a senior mentor who is the mentor who started explaining when teacher is not available in the class, he used to bitterly teach the subject in front of his group, his 10 students. This was going on. So peer learning plays a vital role in the classroom. Very important is focusing on mastery. So mastery is very, very important in blended learning. So especially integrating technology as well as normal face-to-face classroom is really important. Next platform is virtual learning. Virtual learning is nothing but what? Again, it is behind the screen on computer, like how we are doing webinar now. So that is what virtual learning. But as Prem Kumar sir told, very important thing is inquiry-based or project-based learning. You know, I always tell one word to my teachers is, it is very difficult for any teacher to satisfy all 30 students in the classroom. But as a teacher, please try to reach out to the student whom you consider to be the average most. Please understand, a teacher, now in the olden tradition system, lecture matter was going on and rote learning was the common platform of learning. Where teacher is to go to class 2, 1s, 2, 2, 2s, 4, 2, 3, this was happening earlier. Those were the days gone now. Now today's era, 21st century learning requires interaction. 21st century learning requires communication. 21st century learning requires inquiry-based learning, where we should allow students to ask n number of questions. See, I used to tell my teachers, please allow students to ask 2 into 200 times. Please, don't make them quiet. Let them get the chance of speaking with you. Let them ask n number of questions. And if you feel tired, you answer, but you have to answer. Don't ignore any child in the classroom because each child is important for us. So inquiry-based learning, as Prem Kumar sir told, it plays a vital role in the classroom. Even project-based learning, see, as Madam Papri Ghosh told, that English chapter can be integrated with some kind of project. Even physics, as Prem Kumar sir told, some students will not like physics subject. Yeah, I was also not liking physics, even though I am a biology person. So I was also not liking physics. That's why I took my subject like CMZ. Okay, generally science students, many will not like physics because physics sometimes they will not understand. It is like a raw subject, some of them will develop phobia against physics. But you can make, Papri Madam told that, see, we had one professor, he made entire student like aeronautic engineers. So I was very happy to listen to that. So please understand, project-based learning in physics will play a vital role. Please give project. You know, Sir Gulshan sir told initially, so do you know to keep the bulb at home? So bulb lagane aata hai kya? Okay. So Sirji, main aapko ek bolta hu, see, main bulb bhi laga sakta hu, wiring bhi kar sakta hu. So mere thode se bacche har kuch kar sakte hain. So because the project-based learning is really required. So we have to give project and we have to give student a chance to explore the possibilities, and they have to use the technology at home also. So that is required. So project-based learning plays very vital role. And integrating technology with education, now it is going on, it will go. Then very important is global connection. Now, better than me, Gulshan Sharma sir has got knowledge of connecting globally. So inshallah, I'll also try to connect globally. So global connection plays a vital role because nowadays it is very easy to fly to any country because everywhere there are flights and we can go and land one day, in next day in any other country. So because of this globalization, the global environment and global education, we have to compete with the entire globe, and the students should be ready to compete with the students of the entire globe. And this will happen when there is uniformity in the education system. Across the globe, there should be uniformity in the education system. Across the globe, the skills should be improved. The students should be taught the skills to handle the problem. Skills to handle the tools, skills to handle the various technical aspects of education. And until and unless we don't teach skills in our subject, we cannot be globalized. We can never be globalized. So globalization is happening. And lastly, see, remember, our CBSE from past 2 years, it is telling experiential learning and game-based learning, joyful learning. See, please understand, learning will happen only when students develop interest. Students should have interest to learn. And that is in the hand of the teacher to create that interest among the students. How Papri Madam told, my son was not liking physics, but suddenly by seeing the physics teacher, he developed passion towards physics. Now he is aeronautic engineer. So the teacher should create the passion among the students. We can create many more Sachin Tendulkar. We can create many more Amitabh Bachchan. We can create many more Virat Kohli. Only when the teacher has the passion. The teacher should have the passion to create such kind of student. Even we can create 110 Einsteins, provided the passion should be created among the students. The passion should be created. And that is there in the hand of teacher. Every teacher can create a gen. Every teacher can create an intelligent person. See, I remember, I think Gulshan sir knows one of the famous personality whom we met also recently. Sir used to tell us, every child is born genius. Every child is born genius. Now to explore that, the teacher has, the teacher can play a vital role. Make the genius more genius and give it to the society. That is what we need. And teacher plays a vital role in creating this joyful learning, game-based learning in the classroom. Now what happened, because of this COVID and Corona, students are staying at home, but yet they are learning from the teachers. Face-to-face learning, it is happening through Zoom. But this learning is called as student-oriented learning or self-oriented learning, which is happening among the students. If you see this next slide of mine, this is the old method, which is called as printed instruction is given. This is the older method. Now, 21st century our blended learning system involves teacher-led instruction one side, web-based assessment. You know, nowadays, as we all know that, I have seen a few parents coming for admissions. If a child is very small and the child is only around 1.5-2 years old, and they come for admission for the elder one, but I see the smaller one who comes, he will have or she will have mobile in their hand. Because now children are born in Wi-Fi era, mobile era. We were born in cycle era. That is the difference. Now, the information is available everywhere. The children concentration is screen-centric concentration. Everybody is focusing on screen. Everybody is studying on screen. Now, very important is web-based assessment, web-based learning plays a very, very important role in blended learning. And now many more softwares, many more technologies has come. They are spreading information across. Many of them are free of cost. And there are many more companies. They are supplying the software directly where digital learning, virtual learning, e-learning is happening. And this will be the future of education in coming centuries. We cannot see the olden schooling system henceforth. Corona is there or not there, we don't bother. And today there was a news that I was hearing small news before coming to this webinar, that a person who is asymptomatic about Corona, he cannot spread Corona to others. Means it will not spread with him. So there's some asymptomatic patient will be safer, or he cannot spread Corona. So this is a good news for all of us. So what will happen? So Corona is there or not, but blended learning will happen in future. This will be the futuristic school. Technology will play pro-vital role in the education system in coming century to come, or coming century. So I'll go to my next slide. Just for information, 76% of educators believe that blended learning helps the students perform better, and half of all the schools have already adopted to this approach. Then over 60% of students feel more comfortable expressing themselves to classrooms that use blended learning. This approach can also be improved their testing scoring system. About 70% of school already reduced the cost by moving through teaching admin system and data sharing to cloud-based learning. You know, now, because of this COVID, now, nobody is coming to school building. The school buildings are remaining vacant. Now, cost-effective method of teaching is happening where, which is happening on online platform, where the teachers are teaching through videos or through online system. So it is cost effective. And I'll go to my last but one slide here. Developing resilience is important. Flexibility and adaptability is important. Since the children are staying at home, emotional intelligence plays a very, very important role. Because other day I was hearing from one psychologist, he was telling that in Corona, emotionally people will be down. But I don't see such kind of things. Our Gulshan sir is more active now. So we cannot be emotionally down. We can be more active. But hopefully, even emotional intelligence also plays a very, very important role. Learning should be continuous, and creative and critical thinking will play very, very important role. Then this is my slide. These are 21st century skills. Madam spoke about communications. Yes, communications will play very, very important role in futuristic education. Collaboration, as Prem Kumar sir told, sharing knowledge is important. Our sir, Gulshan sir, is also sharing knowledge amongst everybody. Now, I think he was telling he will reach more than 1 million in within August 15. I appreciate that, sir. Definitely, I appreciate that. So I wish you good luck, and definitely you will reach more than 2 million. And please, you are sharing and collaborating, and you're sharing knowledge. That is very, very important. And connect, and you're doing this kind of webinars. That is your creativity. Creativity also plays a very, very important role. Critical thinking, very important role. Life skills. Life skills are the 21st century skills. Changing bulb, removing Stephanie and fitting it. Everything will come under life skills. These are very, very important. Then problem solving technique. We should have the ability to solve bigger problems. Whatever might be the problem, we should not sit with the problem. We have to solve the problem. So that is a 21st century skill. Flexibility. You should adapt to every system. Either you're going for blended learning, either you're going for online learning or virtual learning, either you're going for hybrid learning, either you're going for video flip learning. You have to adapt. And very important thing, unless and until you take initiative, nothing will happen. So these are all 21st century skills. Initiatives will be very, very important. Taking initiative is very important in 21st century skills. Please read this last slide of mine. That is, it is not just about ideas. It is about making ideas happen. Please do it. It is not just about ideas. It is about making ideas happen. Please do it. As I initially told, parents will play pro-vital role in life of every child. Parents are playing pro-vital role in life of every child. Now, parents to become surrogate teachers. At home, parents are surrogate teachers. The parents to set up flexible school classroom schedule at home. Parents to be peer partners. Parents are peer partners for the students. It will require the parts of patience. Patients play a very important role during this lockdown and COVID period, as well as tensity. Tensity and patience will play a very, very important role during this COVID situation. And since there was time constraint, I'm not taking much of your time. I conclude by thanking Dr. Gulshan Sharma, sir. I think I added value. I wanted you to be healthy always, always young, and conduct many more webinars like this and spread awareness of education among the society. Jai Ho, Jai India, Jai Bharat. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you very much, Syed Shaukat Ali ji. What a wonderful thought process you have given to all of us. All your slides are beautiful. The last slide which you have given, the 21st century skills, ladies and gentlemen, our chamber, International Chamber for Service Industry, is beaming out to the world every day. If I share, you'll be surprised to know, right from Mongolia, coming to the Central Asia, to the Canada, we are linked up everywhere world over, and we are giving two areas. One is the life skills and second is the living skills. because your etiquette, your manners, your gesture, your body language, your personality, your communication skills, everything is coming along with the technical skills. So today, Kuwait, Muscat, and Sultanate of Oman.
Sir, Qatar, we, sir, I'm correcting
yes,
you.
Yes, Qatar. So I extend a very warm invitation to all of you, all our brothers and sisters, those have joined today for this particular program. We would be more than happy that our finishing school extends this facility to these three places, Qatar, Oman, Kuwait. When I talk about, so we'll go to all the three places, kindly bind all the teachers, all the educators, all the visionaries, all the policy makers, because Premji's first point was going so deeply into me when he mentioned that somewhere there is a pain to hear that the CBSE syllabi has not been revised for the last one decade. I've noted that point very carefully. So there are a couple of things which have been taken. All the young boys and girls, those are there in these three countries, these three areas, and this entire continent, count on us. Our chamber would be more than happy to help out and empower the entire eco and the education system in this area. And at the same time, all our brothers and sisters, those have joined from the world over, and even people, those are dreaming in the middle of the night in Australia, New Zealand, and they have taken half the sleep over there. You'll be surprised to know, like a cricket match, some of the people, they remain awake, and after this program, they go to sleep. And I'm thankful to AP Sharma ji. I'm thankful to Mr. Tomar. I'm thankful to all other dignitaries. Of course, in India, Swarnima Luthra ma'am and others, those are packaging the entire program of school education, basic education, foundation together, and helping us to reach out the global fraternity wherever it is possible. All my advisors, my research people, and our presidents of the chamber in different countries, 149 countries, we salute you for giving all the love, affection, and inputs for this program. And before I close down, because Prem Kumar ji is folding his hand, Shaukat Ali ji is also, and I salute Papri Lady, and I say, ladies and gentlemen, है प्रीत जहां की रीत सदा है प्रीत जहां की रीत सदा मैं गीत वहां के गाता हूं भारत का रहने वाला हूं भारत की बात सुनाता हूं ऑल ऑफ अस टुगेदर फ्रॉम इंडिया ग्लोबल बाइंडिंग टुगेदर एंड बाय द टाइम 15th ऑफ अगस्त भारत के स्वतंत्रता दिवस तक वी वुड लाइक टू हैव मैंने तो 1 million सोचा था शौकत अली जी ने 2 million ले गए तो अब मेरा काम और बढ़ा दिया प्रेम कुमार जी लगेंगे इस काम में और पापरी मैडम भी लगेंगी इस काम में और जितने भी मेरे भाई बहन मेरे बच्चे मेरे कलीग्स माय चिल्ड्रन मैंने बच्चे इसलिए कहा क्योंकि 70 ईयर की एज में मैं वो लिबर्टी ले सकता हूँ आई एम 20 ईयर बट माई बायोलॉजिकल क्लॉक इज 20 सो माई डोपामिन टेल्स मी All my children world over, let's join together. Let's empower the education system. Let's empower the humanity. It's only and only and only education which can bring a global peace and prosperity and growth and a happy living. Thank you very much. Thanks for joining. Wish you all a wonderful, lovely evening. Shab e khair, Jai Hind, good evening, and all the best to everybody. And Prem Kumar ji, for you, right coming from Kerala. Yennam ventarathin aadum nevela Yashamala saran kochum nevela All the best to everybody. Good night. Good night. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.